Hello and welcome, Asian Network community. My name is Sergey Heck, and I want to thank you, all the Asian Network community and Shaheen to participate me here. And I have the topic today to talk about decentralized finance. And I will directly share my screen to don't waste your time. And now you should see my screen. Perfect, wait a second. Now you should see my screen. Perfect. So, and in my topic is to show you how decentralized finance can disrupt your financial life. Okay. And it will be a bit technically, but it's the future, and it's important that you listen to this topic, because in the time that we have right now in the pandemic, the government printing money unlimited, and therefore you need alternative transfers, alternative ways to where you can hedge against the fiat money. And before I start, I want to introduce myself, that you better know me. So my name is Sergey Heck, and I become from an assembly line worker at a big automobile company in Germany. I become a successful author, multi entrepreneur, and investor. And I also known as one of the most successful network marketers in Germany and Europe. And I established in the last 5 years a sales organization with over 330,000 partners in network marketing in the recent years. And also in the last years, I could create my brand. I created the company Blockchain Hero and Coin Korea, that are crypto news websites in German speaking countries, and also a crypto marketing agency in Switzerland. And because of the success, I wrote a book in German, so for the German community, because I'm from Germany and Switzerland. And I helped thousands of people how to become successful in network marketing. And that makes me, of course, very, very proud. And also, what I'm very thankful for is that I met amazing people, and especially I met the top salesman, Jordan Belfort. It's the Wolf of Wall Street. Maybe you know more. Also, of course, you know Eric Worre, the network legend, and also one of my dreams come true. I met Arnold Schwarzenegger, so a role model for me, and that makes me very, very proud. And and that was about me. And now I want to talk about DeFi, so decentralized finance. And this is the topic, how can this disrupt your financial life? So what is DeFi? DeFi is, like I told you, it's a decentralized finance, and it's a movement that uses open source and distributed networks to transform traditional financial products into a reliable and transparent protocol without intermediates. What that means, so you see on the left, we have the traditional financial system. Here you see that we have one entity who controls everything. So they can decide everything, they can print money if they want, and so on. And in a decentralized financial system, you see everything is open source, and you have P2P networks, and you see there's no middleman, so no entity that everything controls. Yeah, it's fully automated. So these are the big differences to traditional and decentralized. And I want to go more deeply, a comparison from traditional to DeFi. So in the traditional, you see the issuing of money is the state, the entity. And in the DeFi, you have the proof of work and proof of stake rewards. In the tradition, by transferring money, you have in the traditional cash or bank wire. Then on fintech, you have Revolut or TransferWise. So it going more online and more automatic. And in DeFi, we have cryptocurrency and token transactions. Okay. And what about lending and borrowing money? You have the banks in the traditional, you have lending clubs like in the fintech space, and in DeFi, you have tokenized P2P debts. And exchanging assets, you have in traditional exchanges and brokers like NASDAQ. And in DeFi, you have decentralized exchanges. And if you want to invest money, you can use in this traditional way, stocks, bonds, etc., through banks and exchanges. In fintech, maybe many people know Robinhood is what's also already amazing. And in the DeFi, you have tokenized financial products like you can jump into ICOs, STOs, or you can just buy token and create baskets. Okay, so these are the differences between traditional to DeFi. And what I want to tell you is also that also what makes DeFi so special is that you have very, very less bureaucracy. So because in the traditional, you have so much bureaucracy, you have many employees, and less automation. In the fintech, you have more automation, but you still have a bit bureaucracy. You have some of staff that you need to pay. And the big advantage on DeFi is that you have, like I told, no middleman. You have no bureaucracy. It's full automated, and it's all running by a protocol. Okay, so we don't, there's no middleman needed. It's full automatically, and therefore you have very, very less fees. Very less fees, nearly to zero, and that makes this so special. And you see here, I want to share a screenshot with you from DeFi Pulse. It's the biggest tracking website for DeFi, and you see in March, on the 15th March, we had in DeFi projects around $600 million that were invested, okay, in DeFi projects. And now, after 4 to 5 months, it makes a 10x. So we have right now over $7.09 billion that are invested in DeFi. And why is that so? Because, of course, we have right now the pandemic, we have many people don't trust the government, and therefore more people go to DeFi. And and that are only the nerds who going right now in the DeFi space, because we have right now one problem. So you are now one of the last people who know maybe about that. Yeah. But right now there's one problem in DeFi. Not many people or normal people know about the companies in the DeFi space. You don't know it. Do you know a Maker? Do you know Compound? Do you know Synthetics? Do you know these companies? I think not. Yeah. And it's also difficult for these DeFi tech teams to do great marketing, to build a community around their products. Like we can. We as network marketing leaders, we can do that. But they cannot do it. They have another focus. Yeah. And that's a niche that we have right now. And these we want to solve with Market Peak. So we combine with Market Peak the company's world of AI, fintech, crypto, blockchain, and tokenized assets with the community of investors, buyers, affiliates, and prospects. Okay. And especially we're focusing on the market. So it's a platform where we're focusing on the marketing, on the education. So we teach you what is DeFi, we teach you marketing, we teach you leadership, all what also network marketing needs, and we reviewing the projects. And on top of the platform, they can join projects and products, so third party projects and products, also affiliates or network marketers can join, and of course investors and buyers. Yeah. And how it works. So I want just show you this slide. You can see that you can invest through our platform for exclusive conditions in project products and education that are around blockchain, around DeFi. So that I wanted to share with you. And the market, why now? So the DeFi market is the DeFi and the tokenized market, it is at the beginning right now. Yeah, you see that we have right now 2020, we have now a volume around $1 trillion, but the projection is that we will have on 2027 our projected tokenized market volume of over $24 trillion. Okay, and that's in reality possible, because you saw the other DeFi pools that only in 4-5 months it 10x'd. So in 7 years it can really blow up, because the advantages are much more than in the traditional finances, okay? And that what I wanted to show you, that you think about it and maybe got informed more about decentralized finances, because this will be the future. I'm very sure about that. And also we have of our project, our own Peak token, what we distribute to over 90% to the community, where you get discounts, you get more commission to rewards plan, you get more voting power, and you get airdrops. And it's not a just blah, blah, we want to do this. No, we already delivered. We have already our Peak token on the Ethereum blockchain. And yeah, you can check this on Etherscan. Etherscan is the explorer for the Ethereum blockchain. And you can check out that we are already listed there with our smart contract. The Peak token is also already audited by a third-party company and is already listed on 6 exchanges that you see now here. And our goal is also to list it at the end of the year, at least to one top tier one exchange like Binance, Huobi, or OKX. And yeah, our new product, it could interesting you. It's because it's for free. It's a non-custody wallet. So our product is the Peak DeFi wallet. Yeah, it's a one-stop solution for taking control of your decentralized finances. It's a native in-wallet app for DeFi solutions for everyone. So you can just download the app for your Android smartphone or App Store, and you can just use all applications that are around the world. So that is not affected to our company. We just offer this product for free. And you can, for example, use Maker, use Compound, or all other projects that are on DeFi pools listed. And we launched this product 3 weeks ago, and we already have over 2,000 downloads. So that makes also that very amazing. Here you see how it is. And yeah, about I want to quick show you the roadmap about for the Peak ecosystem. If you go down to the August 2020, where we are now, we already have 22,000 members. We launched the Peak DeFi wallet. And yeah, in October, we will launch our Peak DeFi fund that I will explain you later now. And we want to get listed on one top tier one exchange. December 2020, we want reach 50,000 members. Next year, more than 250,000 members, and 2022, over 500K members. And our next product, what I told you, is that what I told you before. So we also preparing to create a Peak DeFi fund, yeah, where investors can anonymous and decentralized invest in a fund that will be also managed decentralized and anonymous by fund managers, yeah? And therefore, we will have a performance-based DeFi fund because bad traders get less reputation and good traders will get good reputation, and therefore they get more from the assets under management, okay? And the profits will be shared to the investors, affiliates, and the managers. And the comparison between traditional and traditional funds like hedge funds versus DeFi funds are the following. So at the traditional hedge funds, you have a centralized, mostly one entity behind. You have upfront fees before the investment. You have mostly one trading strategy by one entity, less transparency about all executed trades, and generally a higher fee structure due to bureaucracy and employees. And at DeFi funds, you have here a performance-based DeFi fund, which is fully decentralized, no middleman behind. It's full driven by a smart contract. You have no upfront fees, many traders with different strategies. Best traders get more assets under management to trade, and therefore we can guarantee a performance-based fund. And it's completely transparent by the Ethereum blockchain. And you, of course, have very, very less fees because of the full automation, Okay, so these are the big differences between traditional and between decentralized funds if you compare them. And also I want to introduce shortly the team. I'm the CEO, like I mentioned before. Also we have in the management David Gladys. He's from the beginning. He's from 2014 in the blockchain space. He's our blockchain visionary. And also we have our CTO Benjamin Bendig, who is our blockchain expert and IT expert. And also we have more than 11 team members that you can see on our homepage, and every one of us has a LinkedIn account. And also, yeah, we are based in Dubai, Silicon Oasis, because our focus markets are Europe and of course Asia. Yeah, Asia is one, our biggest market. We have a big community right now in Vietnam and South Korea, and we're joining now China and so on. And yeah, it would make me proud if you also check our community out. And if you're asking right now how you can be a part of our community, we have lifetime memberships. So you can join for free, or you can use one of our memberships starting from $125 lifetime. And we have three pillars in each package. One pillar is education, where we teach you about crypto, network marketing, leadership, mindset. Second pillar is the reward system. The bigger the package, the more commission you get from the compensation plan. And the third pillar is you can participate from our peak minting software, where you every month get peak tokens minted. Yeah, and this peak token you can then sell on the exchanges where we already listed, yeah, and can make them to cash, or you can just hold the peak token and participate from the benefits. So these are, yeah, the packages if you want to be a part of our community. And I have a special deal to all Asian network participants. If you become a member by the link below, 4people.io/DeFi protocol, then you will get a free peak airdrop. Yeah, and I want to show you, if you go to the link 4people.io peak DeFi protocol, this is how the website it looks. You can completely join for free here if you click the bat button, and if you do these three steps, yeah, then you will get a free peak airdrop. And of course, also we have a compensation plan in our system, but that I don't want to tell you here. And yeah, it would be great to have you in our community. If not as a networker, then of course as an investor, because I know that here are also many networkers who are maybe, who of course in another company, and I don't want to pick you from there, of course not. But as an investor, maybe it's something interesting for you, and you can just try out and take a look on the platform. So, and yeah, I go back to the presentation. Yeah, so yeah, that was the last slide. So the deal is limited to 72 hours. And yeah, I want to say thank you to all Asian networkers. Thank you for the stage here. And yeah, I wanted to, yeah, now I'm open for questions, if you have any questions.
Okay, Mr. Heck, we have some questions from the listeners. So the first one here is that, how do we know that it will be the future, and how will DeFi be accepted by the governments and banks?
Yeah, so first of all, how we can know that? So we can know that everything what is more comfortable for the users and it is more fast and what you can and what is cheaper always compete against other systems. Yeah, we saw it at the development of the iPhone or of the smartphone. Yeah, because it was more user friendly. You have everything in one pocket. Yeah, everything in your pocket, and that's the same with DeFi. You can with DeFi, you can send money borderless. If you want now to transfer money from United States to China, let's say an amount of $50,000, then it would take maybe 1 week until it's there via bank wire. Through DeFi, you can send this amount maybe only for in a few minutes, yeah, and maybe in a few seconds, and you pay so less fees. You will pay around $10 to $20 fees, maybe less, yeah, depending on the transaction the gas limit right now. But if you do it in the traditional finance, you will pay much more for this transaction, yeah. And about the regulation. Yes, right now worldwide, there the DeFi space is very new. It's not that much regulated, but it's like as Bitcoin were created 2009. Yeah, many governments after that forbid Bitcoin or tried to create something on their own. But what happens after 10 years? Many countries now accepting Bitcoin because Bitcoin was decentralized and gets so much network effect that that hundred thousands of users already using it, and and therefore the governments decided now to create concepts how they can adopt regulation into the Bitcoin space, and that the regulatory will also do with DeFi concepts. We have already the first the first projects that are invested by Coinbase, for example. Coinbase is a United States crypto company which is SEC regulated, and they also invest and work together with the first DeFi projects. Yeah, I hope I could answer the question good.
Okay, that was great. That was a great answer. Now, we have another question here. So what makes Peak Token different from other companies?
Yeah. So we our focus is not like many other crypto companies that want to create own blockchain, for example, with their own coin to get adoption, that we can you can pay with the coin the food or other stuff. No, we especially want to create a DeFi fund and DeFi products where our token is involved in our products. Yeah. So, for example, if you want to use our DeFi fund, yeah, you need to stake as a fund manager our Peak tokens, and in the moment that when you stake, yeah, you also create you lock the peaks up. And also what no company has right now, we also, because we are of course network marketers, we also implemented the function of the Peak token. So if you stake the Peak token, you also get more commission. And there are many other functions where the Peak token is implemented in other our products, yeah. And also therefore we're using the Ethereum blockchain, so we don't use our own blockchain, because why not use a blockchain which already has the most adoption behind Bitcoin? Yeah. And that makes us a bit different from other companies. And if you compare us right now with other crypto MLM companies, we deliver already so much compared to them, because we know that many scams out there. And I showed you already some proofs that we are audited, that we are already on the blockchain, we are already on some exchanges, and we are already delivering real products. And yeah, that makes us different from the other companies.
Okay, and another question here from one of our listeners. So what are the advantages of crypto in this time of the pandemic?
Many cases, to be honest, yeah, many things. So in times of pandemic, yeah, you can, like I told, maybe if you, for example, in a country where you cannot easily go out, yeah, you can just do transactions online. You can do it from your smartphone. You can do transactions from your laptop and just send money. So Bitcoin or Ethereum or stable coins, you can send to another member, or you can buy something all over the world, and you don't need to fly to have cash with you. You don't need to go to the bank. So it's one of the cases. And the another case, what we see, if we just take the Bitcoin, the mother of all cryptos, then you can see that that Bitcoin have a quite similar development after the pandemic, like gold and silver, and they are going very well after the Corona crisis started in March April. And it's a what I want to say, it's a great hedge to the traditional financial fiat money like the US dollar, because the government is so much printing money right now, and it's a great hedge to have some Bitcoin, some Ethereum against the hyperinflation. And many big investors already told that officially, like Paul Tudor, like Grayscale Institution, and also nearly, I think, last week, the Fidelity Fund announced that they expect Bitcoin until 2026 or 2027 to a price of $1 million.
All right. Thank you for those wonderful and inciting information about DeFi. And we hope that our listeners here would, you know, register soon. So we invite them to register to your page. And also, thank you very much for your talk, Mr. Heck. It was a very, very informative one.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And I wish also to your community all the best, and have a great, great journey, and stay well, stay healthy, stay safe, and hope you join our community. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Bye.